Being a Christian in the world of today, I know it may seem difficult. Living the life that you have been called to lead may seem impossible. But when you possess the principal thing, you are not just transformed, but you are empowered to live the fullness of the life of Christ. To live the God kind of life. To live a life of a believer.
This life that I have is a life of God in me. This life that I have is a life of Christ. This joy that I have is the joy of the Holy Archer.
In 1 minute, can you just lift your hands? Pray in the Spirit. Pray in the Spirit. Oh, bless His name. Oh, Rabba Shai. Oh, Kabarani Gabaso Meleteli Mahane. Lord, we acknowledge you for the life of God that is in us. Ameleko Barate. Come on, open your mouth wide and give Him glory.
Why are you all suddenly quiet? Oh, you are reading. You are reading. What's your reading? What do you have next?
PBS.
JB. PBS. Bring out the PBS note, though. You cannot see my rights. That's your problem. And have you submitted your math assignment?
Yes.
Let me check it. If you get zero, I'll beat you even hell out of you. You know me now. I said bring out your PBS note.
It's in the staff room.
Yes.
It's in the staff room.
Yes.
Cause we all make mistakes sometimes, and we all step across that line. But nothing sweeter than the day we find, we find.
It's hanging over him like the clouds of Seattle. It raining on his swag, falling deeper in the saddle. It's written on his face, he don't have to speak a sound. Somebody call the 5-0, we got a man down. Now you can go and play it like you're all rock and roll, but guilt does a job on each and every man's soul. And when your head hits the pillow at the nightfall, you can bet your life that it's gonna be a fight, y'all. Cause we all make mistakes sometimes, and we've all stepped across that line. Nothing sweeter than the day we find forgiveness, forgiveness. And we all stumble and we fall. Bridges burn in the heat of it all. But nothing sweeter than the day we call out for forgiveness. We all need, we all need. We all need forgiveness. We all need, we all need.
Mr. Lecrae, my mama told me what I would be in for if I kept all this anger inside of me pent up. My heart been broken, my wounds been open, and I don't know if I can hear I'm sorry being spoken. But those forgiven much should be quicker to give it, and God forgave me for it all. Jesus bled forgiveness. So when the stones fly and they aim at you, just say forgive them, Father, they know not what they do.
Now you can go and play it like you're all rock and roll, but guilt does a job on each and every man's soul. You know, and when your head is the pillow at the nightfall, you can bet your life that it's gonna be a fight, yo. Cause we all make mistakes sometimes, and we've all stepped across that line. But nothing sweeter than the day we find.
Thank you.
me to our mock room, customer team. Well, are you taking a bite? Are you holding a bite?
Oh, we are working on our business.
I know. Hey, something comes to my concern now.
Eh?
I noticed room beautifully. I don't know if you noticed room beautifully. Oh, I don't see now, but I guess you see the paper.
So, when Pastor was preaching on that, his lady you're looking at her.
Pastor Max, it's not like that now. You know, provided the fact that she's a new member, she has to attend Rivers Foundation concern for.
Yeah, so you're the evangelism head, Abby. I know the head of what they will call it, so drama department.
I know.
What was that drama department with
I know.
Evangelism.
I know.
Well, what happened?
Pastor Matthew, how did you know her?
You know, we have our ways.
Your ways?
I was not looking at her like you. When Pastor was preaching, I was focusing on what Pastor was saying.
Man of God! Hey, besides Pastor Matthew, the prayer session led to the it was really powerful.
You have gone back to that matter again.
I noticed the way Pastor Macy was looking at you. She was looking at you.
You have talking about woman matter again. Why was woman be always involved in your conversation?
Pastor Matthew, even the church knows that Pastor Macy likes you. It's
God.
Obvious.
My God. How do you know? Are you the Holy Ghost?
How
you sense what is in the mind
it's
of
what
the,
I know,
the,
sir.
The members?
It's what I know.
I told you that guy just speaking like that.
I even know him. I know him.
You know him?
Yes. He's my old mate.
Your old mate?
He's my old mate. I know him. He stays in my home.
Wow.
Yes. Wow. Even my roommate has joined him. He has joined the
team. Of
Yao Boy. Yao Boy is a cook one. A very cook one.
And you're living in that same house.
I don't have any choice now, Pastor Matthew. What do you require? That's where I got to be since 100 level to 200 level. I don't have any choice.
Lord, I pray so day. I am so grateful you gave me food. Sir, you gave me joy. Jehovah, he
gave me food. I'm going to drive. I'm going to drive. I'm going to drive.
It's not a bit like that. If you don't say you don't get money, if you don't talk, as before you enter now. Exactly. If you don't help you, you don't beg, you just enter like that. It's not a bit like that too. I don't hear, but next time, she cannot do like that.
Brandy, about to go to the
because I can see you are going for test, right?
I don't know my number of
them. You don't have to say that now. Just give me your number, then you just go for your test. Then we'll talk better.
Okay. I had the conversation with you, and I'm sorry to bust you up, but I'm not that kind of girl. I'm not that type of girl at all. At all. I'm not fit into that concept.
You're not that type of girl. Wow. You're not that type of girl. But all that girls don't ask for money now. They don't beg for money. You shouldn't be saying this. Now all those girls don't beg for money. They are using latest iPhone, they are using latest car. And you're asking me you're not that type of girl. Come on. Rubbish.
Boss,
leave her alone. She says she's not that type of girl. Now she should go. They asked me for one night stand now.
Hey.
Don't worry, she go come back. No be me. She go come back. Don't worry, leave her. When poverty wants to finish her life, she go come back. She will ask me for one night stand. Leave her. She's still deformed. I'm very sure that she's a fresh out. Or she does keep it.
The big boys. Now you the wrong kitty, you the wrong get.
When somebody wants to call her back, I mean, pick up now. You know, pick up when somebody needs you. Hello, mommy.
How are you, my
mommy,
daughter?
Mommy, I'm not fine.
What happened?
Mommy, you know, imagine what happened to me.
What?
Like, I received the worst insult of my life. Hey. I was supposed to go to school today to do a test. And can you believe, on 900 naira, I do not have for transport. Mommy, 100 naira.
Hey, what can we do? Just drown me for your exam. At least you do well, dear.
Oh, to God be the glory. I actually did it though. But mommy, you will not even now imagine the worst happened.
Hey,
mommy, can
what?
You imagine one highly demented me tweet wanted to get in bed with me because of the 100 naira, just common 100 naira. Mommy is disgusting now. Hello, mommy, are you there?
Mommy, the same thing happened to me 2 weeks ago when I was at your uncle's place. In fact, it's because of I refuse that the same thing is happening to you.
That stupid man. Mom, talk to him about someone else.
I don't really blame him, my dear. He has what we need, and I don't even think I can hold
it. Mommy, you cannot hold what? What are you saying now, mommy? No, don't go there. Mommy, we are God's children. We are the Abba's daughter. Have you forgotten what he said? He said his covenant will not break with us. Mommy, he cannot fail us. All we have to do is just stand firm in him. And we should hold him, mommy. Please don't give up, Pedro. Hey, shake mama.
I hear you, my daughter. Yes, thank you.
Mommy, and please, always remember his words. He said with prayer and supplication, we should make our request known to him. Mommy, please don't give up. I beg you. Mommy, please. This is not easy for me to.
How about you?
Yes,
we shall surely summon this one.
Amen,
oh, dear God of our troubles, not Matt.
Yes, ma'am. Take care of yourself. Yes. Wow, no. But wait though. Everything that happened today is still like, it's still doing me like film tricky. Amy, Abba's jewel. One new couple now wanted to get in bed with me because of 100 naira. But God, do you know that this is not what you told me? Shame you know. No, you promised me that you shall supply all my needs according to your riches in Christ Jesus. Why is it now that it's that same me that suffered for 100 naira? Lord Jesus, just 100 naira. This is not what you promised me, Lord. This is still not what you promised me. My father, this is not what you said. This is not your promise for me. Lord, I am trying my best to stand on your word, but Lord, this is not your promise. This is not your promise. This is not the covenant you made with me.
And if you must say, as I wake up upon the Lord, and if you must say, no. And if you must say, as I wake up upon the Lord, and if you must say, no. I'll be partially free. As I wake up on the Lord, I'll be partially free. I will know I'll flow.
So I'd like to invite him officially now. So, sir, welcome to our edition of Winner's Parade. We're very glad to have you here, sir. Thank you very much for coming. Thank you very much for honoring our visitation. Sir, we'd like for you to shed more light on some things that could be bothering everyone as a believer.
Money group, like baby group, same way money groups. But most time, our youth and we are not patient enough to allow this thing to grow. It's already there in your testing that you are going to make it if you work hard. But we are not patient enough to pay the necessary price to get to the point of controlling such wealth. They want to get it now too. And it's a serious challenge. Why is it a serious challenge? Because we are still going to face the consequences of it later in the future. Because what was said, you can't eat your cake and have it again. the cake they are eating today, they will also have it to manage you tomorrow. And if you want it. It's a mystery. So they are trying to cut off what they're supposed to enjoy in fusion to enjoy it now. So when the fusion now comes, it will be a silence. And whatever thing they do to get it now, they must continue doing it to obtain it. And for how long will it last? That's an answer. How long will it last?
Very much, sir. So now we'd like to take a short break. I'm sure you've enjoyed our short section with our pastor. So now I'd love to go for a short break.
Are you ready to catch fire?
Man of God, man of God.
Ah! Pastor Richard, sir.
Man of God, man of God.
How are you, sir?
I hear you.
Good of
you,
sir.
What do I need to honor this?
No.
Prophetic visit.
Man of God, man of God.
Pastor Richard.
Imagine you are seated here divine the scriptures.
Pastor
Richard.
Pastor Matthew.
What we can do that we are doing.
Richard, that's what you say. That's how you were pouring fire on us.
That was the only ghost came upon me.
What
do I do to deserve this?
Wait, Pastor Martin. Let's look at this situation. Imagine an anointed man of fire. Imagine that seated here, devouring the scriptures again. You are even hungry again. That's the complete Holy Ghost package.
Pastor Richard.
I think we need more people in our church that needs to have this kind of
Pastor course. Richard, let's go inside. I need to get something for you to eat. You came to honor me. I was not expecting you.
No. So how are you doing?
I'm fine.
I'm good.
You should see that. Sir, let's go inside.
No, this place is okay.
It's okay.
It's real, sir.
Yeah.
So, how are you doing?
I've been, we thank God. God has been wonderful, sir.
Recently, I've been having this burden in my spirit.
Burden?
Yes, like a nudging, like, the Holy Ghost was trying to tell me something, you know? But about some weeks now, I've been having some dreams. Recently, even when I wake up, it's difficult to remember those dreams.
Wow.
Do you have those kind of experiences too, like?
It has not been really like dreams per se, but like you are saying, like burdens, yeah, like I see, I've not been able to rest. I don't know, but I wanted to tell you, but
like God
it was not clear.
Trying to say something.
Exactly.
I know I was not the only one feeling this kind of thing. I know I have like minded people like I am.
When
spirit filled people that be feeling this kind of
thing. The word of God says from the mouth of two or three, the truth is established.
Yes, sir.
Thank
you. So how is everything? Hope you have been praying, champ.
Pastor Richard, how can you be asking me that kind of question? I'll be praying, God.
Wow.
I just finished 3 days back or now. Like I've been focusing, I've been visiting God on the altar. God has been speaking, I've been hearing things, like things that will help this our generation, sir.
That's because it's very important, because at this season that we are now, we need to be more prayerful. A lot of things is happening. We need to be more and more prayerful. We need to be more prayerful. You know? And the prayer could be, we need to be more prayerful. So,
But sir, this thing you're talking about, I'm thinking that, you know, you are saying body, I'm also saying body. I'm thinking that we may need to call probably a prayer retreat, maybe 3 days or 4 days. Like all the Christians gather and pray.
You know, the exams are fast approaching, the examination are fast approaching.
That's true.
We came to Olabisi on the Bank University to study. That's what we
primarily, yes, sir.
Oh, you do come because you drag me.
they dragged me. It was only good that caught me.
We came here primarily to study and then God decided to give. He already has purpose for anyone. So I feel this is on us. There's no
the two of us.
I feel this is enough. So we need to intercede and really pray and seek the face of God on this issue. What do you think about it?
I think you are right.
That's what we are going to do. So you know, we are on it now.
We need to pray.
And I'm sure that, you know, when we seek the face of God, God is going to reveal those hidden things to us.
Amen.
Those not like the secret.
Amen.
You know, they are not clear. I don't know why. Maybe because we need to come together. I'm not too sure, but I feel when we come together, you know, forces, you know, they produce greater power. They are greater results.
So,
we need to combine and then let's see what God can do.
Yes, sir.
So,
I'm
sure, you know.
You cannot go like that.
Yes, that is fast.
I need to quickly go and if you just summarize, let me just conjure something together.
I would have beaten. There's a program at the good day and then program is starting by 6 o'clock.
Wow.
It's already 5 or 7 years. I'm going to be going to start with it, so I need to rush. I need to get my way now.
Okay.
I'm very sorry that I didn't eat your. I'm very sorry that we could even go and make a time and then come and eat your food.
I expected that.
I would love to eat your food. I'm sure you're going to be a very great cook.
That'd be a wonderful time.
So,
okay, sir.
I'm saying, I forgot to tell you this. I'll be traveling very soon. And then
you'll be traveling.
Yeah, I'll be traveling. I don't know when I'll be back. So my assistant to
okay, take over. To your
yes, Pastor Steven. So I'm going to take over and then, you know. So just work with him. I'll be joining you in the spirit. So I'll be with you people. And then, but just work with Pastor Steven and then everything.
So, sir, which time will you be back?
I'm not sure. I don't know for sure.
But, I hope there's no problem.
No, I know that. God is in control of every situation.
So we just need to
be rest-minded.
Okay, sir.
So I'll see you once again.
Let me escort you. Let's
thank God.
Ah, God. Ah. Why do you have to lie? Ah. But, Father, I know I was off the path at a point. But I've prayed about this and God has restored me. Ah, God. Ah, I didn't see anything. Ah, I should not have lied. Ah, Father, Holy Spirit of God, forgive me. Holy Spirit of God, forgive me. Ah, Abby, should I go and see my mentor? I think I need help. Maybe I think I will need to see my mentor.
Sister Kenny,
Sister Rose,
how are you?
I'm fine.
Oh, that's good. How was your week?
Ah, fine. Oh,
that's nice. I'm just something.
What is that?
I'm not too sure.
Sister Rose, what is that? Tell me.
It's because you're my friend. That's what I just want.
Will you tell me? I should just
wait,
be going.
Now,
okay.
Papa, don't take it too hard. Too.
Will you tell me?
Sorry. I hate that. Pastor Matthew has a crush on you.
Sister Rose.
What?
How sure are you about that?
I'm not too sure. That's why I said it's a rumor.
How sure are you that it is a rumor?
I saw that it's a rumor.
I mean it. The way he used to look at me, I was suspecting that something is going on.
Stop it. Be calming down. I say it's a rumor. I'm not
rumors
too sure.
Rumors are often true.
That's it, man. So now, why is it? You're lucky, oh. I heard another rumor.
What is that again, Sister Rose?
This particular one. I'm not too sure. Hey, that. Pastor Matthew was supposed to be the president.
Are you serious?
Yes, sir. The board, we are scared of the prayer unit. Yeah. That they will lose fire. That's why they left them.
I knew it. What did he want to tell me that? Pastor Stephen and Pastor Richard are more spiritual than my own Pastor Matthew.
Zero money. Not yet from my mouth too.
This is where
just edit too. Just one last room. Just one last one. I heard that Pastor Matthew has dated Mama before.
Hey!
Yes, sir. You did not even allow me to finish. Wait! I also heard that she is now dating Papa.
Yes! When you go the way you hear all these things,
said it's just a rumor.
Just
somebody cannot tell you rumor.
What? Sister Rose.
When I told you your own, you will help you.
Sister Rose!
Hello, mommy.
Mommy, what are you asking?
Hello, ma. Good afternoon, ma. I'm fine, thank you. Ma, see, she's tired. She just came back from a night vigil. So she's tired. In fact, I went to get something for her today. No, ma, we both went outside to get something to eat. Yes, ma, we're outside the company. I went to accompany your friend to get something to eat. Ma, mommy. Titi has been a good girl. You don't need to keep stalking her. You don't need to keep stalking her. She's a good girl. Since I've known your daughter, Titi, she has changed my life. Me that don't go to church, I now go to church. I now serve God. So your daughter is a good girl. So you don't need to always bug her or something. I will give you food.
Matthew, face here. You see, don't look at those girls like that. You are not to condemn them. See, I'm not. They are not called into the ministry of condemnation, but reconciliation.
Oh, yes, sir. You're right, sir.
So, according to what you are telling me, I've had you, and I'm glad. I'm so glad that finally you've spoken up. This is what you really need. You need to speak up sometimes. You see, concerning your spiritual life, the problem is you are relying on your old strength too much. I've been telling you this several times and times again. See, the Bible even says it is not by power, it is not by might, but by the spirit of the Lord.
Yes, sir.
I don't need to quote Bible to you now. You are the prayer coordinator, for crying out loud.
You're right.
So all this thing, it's just rely on the Holy Ghost to help you. You don't need to know. Begin to do everything by your own strength and everything. That is why spirituality is different from religiosity.
Mm. You're right.
Are you getting me?
Yes, sir.
So, Matthew, can I ask you a question?
Yes, sir.
Have you discovered your purpose?
Yes, sir. I've discovered, but it's not really clear like that.
It's clear?
Yes, sir.
See, Matthew, you need to discover your purpose first. Because it's going to help you a lot. It will give you focus.
Hmm.
And it will guide you in every area of your life. You see, when I discovered my purpose, it was what really helped me.
Wow.
You know, when I discovered I was going into movie production. You know that why?
I remember, sir. I had that time.
So I was very focused. You know, everything I needed to do was to aligning with my purpose for God.
Hmm.
Are you getting my point?
Yes.
So you need to discover your purpose first. It is very, very, very important because it will make you look focused. And it will direct you in the area of your life.
Yeah.
So as I was saying with you.
Yes, sir.
See, another key to be very successful in life is to write down plans.
Wow.
Write your vision and make it plain.
Wow, I think you said that to me.
I've said it to you before, Abi.
Yes,
see, one of those things that helped me was writing down of plans. I know it might sound old school, you might think, that one is... But I'm telling you, it will help you. When you write down your plans, it will help you because nothing moves you than a written plan.
That's true, sir.
It will really help you a lot. Are you getting my point now,
yes,
Matthew?
Sir.
So I want you to just make sure that every plan you have ahead, put them down. And the more you are looking at them, it will drive you.
Sir, but the thing is that all these things you are telling me, I understand. But sir, these things are not really easy. Like it's somewhat difficult.
Matthew, it will not always be easy. That's why the Bible says in 1 Peter 5:8, it says be sober and be vigilant.
Yeah.
Are you getting my point? See, this life we are in is not funfair, it is warfare.
Mm.
If it is easy, then we would have misused the opportunity. That is why this life, everything, you have to take everything as if it is war. It will not look easy. It will not even be easy. Mm. That is the truth. But life is warfare. You have to fight and keep fighting and keep fighting. And that is why you have to keep hearing the word of God. Because it will build your faith. And your faith will be what? It's what will keep you in this warfare. Are you getting my point now,
yes,
Matthew?
Sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
And lastly, Matthew.
Yes, sir.
You must learn how to keep godly friends.
Mm.
Well behave godly friends. It will help you. Your association will determine your destination.
Yes, sir.
It will really help you, Matthew. Learn to keep godly. See, I know you are a student. That's why I'm telling you this. This is a very vital key. This is what students are missing nowadays. Learn to keep godly friends. They are the one that will drive you. Even when your own strength fails you, they will drive you. Are you getting me now?
Yes.
See, Matthew, all this thing I'm telling you, I know that you already know them. You are the prayer coordinator. You already know all these things. But the problem is not knowledge. The problem is application of knowledge. So as I was saying, it is in word practice and not just hearing alone.
Yes, sir.
Am I right?
Yes, sir. You are very right. As you are saying, sir, I think this is that it's actually knowledge application that is missing in my life. I've just been accumulating knowledge, but I've been applying only a few of this knowledge.
See, that is the problem with believers most times. But that does not mean we'll stop hearing. Because faith comes by hearing, and hearing, and hearing, and hearing of the word of God. But the more we hear, the more we do. So that is what we have. I think with this few cues I've given to you, that is what will help you. And see, God's mercy is ever sufficient. I told you earlier then, we are not in the ministry of condemnation. So whenever you find yourself, you know, falling, and it does not mean you have to condemn yourself. God's mercy is ever sufficient. We can't overtake God's mercy. His grace is ever available for us. So apply God's mercy, as I was telling you. God's mercy is ever available. His grace is sufficient for us. You understand me, Matthew?
My love, it has do. Oh yeah. Come and eat now. Would you not eat? In fact, my son, come and eat.
See, we are coming, madam. We are coming. See, better let us go inside. Well, that woman come and drag us now. Matthew, let's go and eat before this woman knows.
Pastor Gloria, can you see what I'm saying?
Man of God, I see the knowledge.
You know, when in the what if calling, it is free. What are you saying?
He said, behold, the bone of my bone is in the flesh of my flesh.
Pastor,
are
you doing?
This is what is
beautiful.
I see it's a perfect combination. Sister, we have to go.
Okay.
talk later. I actually want to go and see Pastor. Something very important now for this one. So God bless you, man. Just take care of yourself. Have a wonderful week, man.
I'm tired. Go home and rest now.
I'm having a headache. I have to have
a all you have to do is just go home and relax.
Hey, your daughter is talking like this. Your sister is meeting her. No, meet her.
Do you know how long we preside over meeting? We take a whole day just to discuss over a matter. See, you go and meet Pastor Richard. You take a day off. I think it's not bad to meet him. Gloria!
Help!
Who is here? Gloria!
Help!
Help!
Somebody help me!
Pastor Gloria, where's that now?
Pastor Gloria!
Just leave.
Pastor Gloria!
Tao sisters, how are you doing?
Projan, I'm fine now.
Do you see what happened?
I saw it too.
What is the cause of that thing? Talk to me now.
I heard something.
What is that?
But don't tell anybody.
Okay.
It's a rumor.
Rumor?
I heard that Star Gloria is pregnant.
That sister that used to do Oli Oli.
He's pregnant.
Faith.
Do you know give her a pregnancy?
Don't tell me that it's Pastor Stephen.
It's Pastor Matthew!
Jesus!
What? Stop shouting now. I told you that it's rumor. Why you shout?
Pastor.
She beats me that it's telling me.
Pastor Matthew.
It's a rumor.
Sir Rose, with all due respect, is that your mouth that will kill you one day?
Please, don't stop.
Who told you that Gloria is pregnant? As for most mad, do you hear that rubbish? You don't spread in gossip.
How dare you? I only heard.
Even though you heard that, wisdom demands that you actually confirm from the person or you actually pray for the person before spreading nonsense over them. You see, Sister Gloria is actually my best friend and she's my roommate. She's not pregnant, she only has secret sex.
Sisters. God, forgive me, oh. Sister, you love gossiping. Go.
And you want to know?
This is a house of worship. This is a place of praise.
Pastor Matthew, Pastor Matthew,
sir,
and you see this? You see everything that is happening?
Sir, actually, I saw something else coming, not this.
Do you mean everything that has been happening is just a tip of iceberg? Or what are you telling me?
Sir, I want you to calm down. Sir,
okay.
Sir, have your seat.
Okay.
Have your seat. So you are pacing around. Calm right. Down.
Okay.
Sir, actually, there's something I wanted to tell Pastor Richard.
Okay, I'm on.
But he's not around. Sir, the time Pastor Richard came to my house and he said some things to me, He actually told me later that he's going to discuss it with you. But sir, I told him, I actually lied when he came. I told him that I've been active in my duty as a prayer court. But the truth is that I've not been active, sir.
Oh, the whole prayer court, you've not even been active in your duty? Sir, who does that?
Sir, actually, personally, I've been passing through some things.
Okay.
Some addictions, some topics have been tying me down and now to let me go.
Jesus.
What?
Sir, this has been happening and you didn't inform me at all. Eh?
Sir, I wanted to inform you, but I didn't know how to say it. So, for the past 2 weeks now, I've not been able to pray.
Eh? You? What did you just say now?
Sir?
Just past 2 days ago. You led us in powerful prayer. So what are you now trying to tell me?
Sir, I've been inside you to calm down, sir. This thing is not just me, sir.
Alright.
There are some other executives like me that have been falling short spiritually. Just to assist in pulling off a brother when you see a brother that's falling, sir.
So you want to be teaching me my duty? You are even preaching to me, alright?
Sir, the Bible says, exalting one another in the faith. Sir, we're to exalt one another. This time, things are different. I've been able to walk with God to a particular point and He has revealed some close to me.
But what assurance are you giving me that I can trust you? Can I trust you at this time?
So, I know what you discussed with Pastor Richard last week, sir, when he left my place.
What we discuss?
Yes, sir.
That's not possible. It's not even. No. That can't be.
Sir.
How do you know? Sir, how do you come about?
Okay. He discussed with you concerning the land of Aguero. He said, the Holy Spirit revealed to me this thing just last night, and he said that there are people in this land called Elas. That is why this land are going with the land of Elas.
Exactly what Pastor Richard discussed with him.
He said, those Elas, something happened to them. They were here years ago. Something happened to them, they died. And when they died, that was when sickness took over the land. Just like you see, people are waiting here. Not just apart from Sister Gloria, a lot of people have been admitted to the hospital. Just in the same way, immorality are happening everywhere. You see, the old boys all over their vehicles, they are doing a lot of sacrifices just for money. So just like that, different things, or different, or even bad things have been happening in the land. So I believe that he told you that we need to pray, and there's something that we need to do, sir.
The Lord is really mighty.
Yes, sir.
Using the foolish things of those who are to confirm the wise.
Yes, sir.
So, sir.
So, sir. What are we going to do about this?
Remember.
Yes, sir.
We are soldiers.
Yes. Yes, sir.
And once we know how to do that,
yes, sir.
It's not giving up.
Yes.
Right?
Yes, sir.
So, soldiers, are you ready?
Sir, I was born.
Part of what I was given as my upkeep in school, drugs was not inclusive in the budget. It was prayer I was praying, and these are the things I was telling God. Drug was not inclusive. So I don't know where to get money to buy the drugs. Because we take money from the money I'm giving, buying drugs, not affect other expenses. God, please, take away this illness now. Sincerely from my heart, and the Lord saw how genuine my prayer was. And I tell you the truth, that is how the illness fizzled off. I never in encounter it all through my soul.
So, are you trying to tell
us
that as a believer, we can make this sickness free? Like,
yes, it's possible.
Hello, Titi, what's up? Hello? Wait, what the f- wait, 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 what happened? What happened? What happened? Calm down. What do you mean? You dey shake, I know you're waiting in the talk. What do you mean? Wait a... Yeah.
Waiting so.
What is Shelley?
Waiting happen.
Hey! Wait, you know... Titi, calm down. Hey, wait, calm down. You... Calm down. See, you see, at this point, I don't feel help you. I cannot help you. See, just call your parents. And see... Yeah, wait, say, wait. Calm down. Hear me, so hear me. No call my number again, no. No call me. Just call your pay. Just call your mommy. No call me again. No. Yeah, mom. This girl, police are arresting boyfriend. Come the
hey.
Mona, down. Block your number. Eh? It's no one
call. That's how matter is bad about one. Having a good plan and knowing how to manage yourself. All fingers, they say, I'm not. Yeah. different students in school, and everyone knows how he or she is coming, and everyone knows his own foundation and where he's coming from. I know the limit I can track, and I know when to take back. Knowing that early morning movement, the sun is not finished, retreat, go to school. Then, in the afternoon or probably in the evening, you are exhausted because of the lecture, many other things, you are tired, you can take back and go. All that is about my master plan. If you plan it well, you can be able to manage it. When I was in school, I think I had an engineer, a triangular lifestyle. That is the only thing I went there to do. I went to study. So I paid attention to my studies. Being a Christian, I also will not regret the spiritual aspect of my life. Every student knows why they are in school. Now my purpose of being in school is to find study. Paying attention to my studies. That is the primary purpose of being in school. That I knew that this is why I'm here. And I paid attention to my studies. Study when I'm supposed to study, be in the library when I'm supposed to be in the library. Sometime, night class. There are many other activities in school. Parties, there are those things that many times I didn't get it. But I choose to be dead to that aspect. I live as if none of such things exist. So that is why I wasn't easily attracted to it. And people that love that aspect, most of them are not always unhappy. You know, the friends you also keep in school, also determines the type of life you also live. So a man who is not spiritually conscious would definitely be a victim of circumstances in life. They're not withstanding. A student should know why he is in school, to study. But beyond studies, just like we all know, it's not our certificate after graduation that position us in life. Beyond that certificate, there are other forces that determine what we become. Matter about gifts, purpose. When you are not in your right place in life, no matter what you do, no matter how successful you are, you will not be fulfilled. That is why let's say my small let's say memory system is a purpose will haunt you. And when we are growing up, our destiny, our purpose is speaking. And it's the duty of your parents to spot it out and help the child to channel his attention towards that area. No matter how common the talent might look like, no matter how simple, that is where that child will be fulfilled. And that child, as he's growing up, should also want to notice. There are some things you know that he knows how to do with ease, with that strong. Pay attention to that element, that is where the light is. Every shining light has a source. And when a light starts shining, everybody will need to look for its source. When one has discovered his purpose and is working and building on it, it becomes a light that will attract attention of men. We need each other in life to make it. But when you are now making friends, you should not know the type of friends you keep. You will make friends that are going where you are going. So you can easily understand each other and know how to help each other. Make friends that are going where you are going. Not friends that are out of the game. So make friends that are heading where you are going. Then the area of boyfriend and girlfriend. You know why you are in school. Boyfriend and girlfriend. The major source of distraction. You'll be distracted one way or another. Okay, if nothing happened, maybe during the time period, your boyfriend or your girlfriend break off from the relationship. He's not that interested. You know, emotional attachment, trauma that we set in. Many students have missed a semester because of that. Some have committed suicide because of that. So, and scripture says something, can one take a coal of fire on his chest and not be burnt? He said, no. You know, this thing will hurt you. Why go into it when the time is not yet? Everything has its time. Scripture speaking in the book of Hebrews, that is it, there is time for everything. Even the dead will not be happy with you. So you have to move on. Drive on. Push it on. And he's speaking to himself. I will surely make it. Challenges will always come. That is one thing in your life. Thank you also letting us know if you got lamentation. Say, let our challenges come to us when we are beautiful. There is still energy within us to be at and to handle it. So when a youth is facing challenges in the future, he should rejoice that they are coming at the right time. It's not when one is old, when there is no longer stamina to bear some shock. That should not be when challenge should come. It's when we are youth. Let it come when we can face it, when we can handle it. May not be silent. As it's coming, God will always give us wisdom. But that is what scripture said, do not have a high priest who did not have a feeling of what our infirmities are. But him by one way or another have created a way of escape for us. God will help every student in school and grant everyone wisdom on how to escape through whichever challenge that comes.
If you want to give your life to Jesus Christ, I know you are believing in sin. The time passed. I've been walking according to the course of this world, the darkness. And you want to separate yourself from this world and then to align yourself to Christ. You want to leave the world of sin and then come to Jesus Christ. Can you signify by raising your hand? If you are here in this garden today, and you want to give your life to Jesus Christ. I'm waiting for you. I'm sure there's somebody here in this place that is listening to me. Is there anyone? Can we see you? Jesus is calling me today. He says, come and see me that you for my every lady. He says, I will give you rest. Thank you very much. I will see you later. Can we stretch out our hands and pray for him and ask the Lord to help him? Satan, you should know that prayer to God that the Lord will save you and the Lord to keep you. Can you commit all your sins to God and tell him to take them away? Receive, ask him to give his life. Are you open your mouth and pray and talk to him? Please let's stretch out our hands and pray and talk to the Lord. That the Lord will keep him. We will not backslide, we will not go back into the world. We will grow and increase in the strength and in the might and in the knowledge of the Lord. We will not go back into the world. For in Jesus' name we have prayed.
Amen.
Father, I pray for this, my brother, that you will keep him in Jesus' name.
Amen.
He has come to know you, will not go back into the world in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You will keep him perfect unto the last day in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
For in Jesus' name we have prayed.
Amen.
Are we celebrating Jesus? Amen. Somebody that you move to decide, somebody we are going to, and then somebody we are going to. Can we give our.
So is there any question or anything that you feel is bothering you that you would like to ask? Just put me and ask.
And there's no saying God cannot forgive us.
Are you sure?
Yeah, look at Paul, for example. He has contributed to believers before he met Christ. And God used him even more than the disciples that were with Jesus during his time. So there's no sin God cannot forgive us. And living the life of a believer is actually easy. You just have to learn how to live the life of a believer, because that's the only life. No, yes, yes. And I believe your story is just beginning and it's going to be stressful.
I have the way. That's your reality. Come on.
Spirit of God.
Lives inside of me. Kind of life.
I have the way.
Is the God kind of life?
Spirit of God.
Is the God.
Sore, sore.
And enema.
Sore.
You believe no, no, me, Baba.
Sore.
The light of God is in me, hallelujah.
Sore.
Oh, no, me, let me, ni, na, na, ma.
Sore.
Lift your hands, sore. Thank you for this life. Thank you for this life.
This life that I have is the life of Christ.
This life,
this life that I have is the life of God.
This life. That's your reality. You have the life of God. The power of God. The wisdom of God is at work in you. Can you sing it now?